I keep a close watch on this heart of mine. I keep my eyes wide open all the time. I keep the ends out for the fight.
Because you're mine,
I hold the line.
Where are we going?
Well, it just ain't no telling.
I find myself alone.
Let's go. Come on, come on, hurry it up.
Rabbit jumped out and
tried
to scare it to death. How are we doing
here? Well, if we switch off.
Y'all have a seat.
What's going on?
Well, I'll tell you. I just ordered my breakfast when I heard they picked you up. I ain't seen the sense in running a perfectly good early bird special. We can talk here as good as we can anywhere else.
You've been at me all night. There ain't nothing to talk about.
The way Parky Sasser tells it, there is.
She says you drove her home from a party at Messler's cabin on the night of the alleged rape.
Yeah, I drove her home, but nothing happened. We just listened to the radio. She was kind of drunk.
You're on that wrestling team at the high school, ain't you?
That's right.
You pretty good?
I got second in my weight class at the regionals.
I guess you could pin a drunk 110-pound girl in no time flat.
Yeah, I could, but I didn't. If anybody was doing the pinning, it was her.
I thought nothing happened.
Want a fry?
I got good onion rings here, too.
Not as good as a do over at Johnny's. He's by day onions over there. Roy, why don't you go give Bobby Slocum a call? Give him a chance to be rounding up bail money. We just gonna sit here and waste time. I'd offer you some fries, Mr. Slocum.
Seems like anything you want.
You just take it, don't you?
Look, I told you I didn't do it.
I hear that gal's pregnant. You heard a rumor like that?
I ain't saying I'm a saint. I'm just saying I didn't rape anybody.
Well, Bobby Slocum don't seem to be real interested in raising no bail money for his own son.
Well, that's a shame, ain't it?
Uncle Lewis,
Oscar, I haven't seen you in a month of Sundays. Where'd that come from?
Yeah, I bought it off Wade Murchison, owns the haberdashery. He snapped up a new model himself.
So who died and left you the mattress money?
Hey, I'm caddy master over at Burning Creek.
That snooty-tooty all-white country club?
Yeah, I match the golfers up with the caddies, make sure they're compatible. Them jackasses who picketed Pickmore and got me fired can't believe it. Yeah, I started at the grill. But the manager's son, he had a summer job managing the kitchen. So I got on his good side by reminding him how smart he was. Because he's Ivy League, Princeton. You know, no Southern school is good enough for him. No, sir. All the while, I'm dropping little hints about how I want to better my situation. So he mentions Oscar Wilson to his daddy. And once Mr. Petty saw how good I got on with his son, he asked me if I thought I was up to being the caddy master. And I told him, yes, sir.
Looks like they pay you by the pound.
Well, I make most of my money in tips. It's how the white folks do business. You scratch my back, I scratch yours.
When the white man ever scratch your back?
I make $15 every week off Haywood Tola just to see to it that his golf shoes is always polished. I'm sitting down talking just as close as you and me right now with the richest white men in town. Man, you fit right in. I mean, they got an opening at the club restaurant if you're interested.
What kind of opening?
Bar back?
Bar back? You mean toting buckets of ice and wiping highball glasses? You better tap your brain and let some of that water run off.
Well, I know how it sounds, but you could clean up in tips. I mean, you put that loquacious tongue of yours to some good use. In no time at all, you'd be head bartender. It sure beat painting churches.
Let me see how I feel at the end of this trip.
Getting your things together now.
I can't believe he gave you the money.
He didn't. I had a little bit hid under the mattress.
Your money. Ma, I'll pay you back.
Don't you worry about that.
Sign there. He had 20 bucks in that wallet there.
So?
So why don't you try paying for it next time?
This ain't none of your damn business, and I'll thank you to keep your opinions to yourself before I knock your crooked teeth down your ignorant throat. Come on, Paul.
Christina.
Hey, Warren. Talking out?
Oh, I wish. I got a 20-minute recess. I thought I'd go back to the office and scour the Supreme Court reporter.
What are you looking for?
A miracle.
Linwood Jenkins?
He's changed his alibi 3 times since lunch. I asked him if he had a relative who might serve as a character witness. He asked me if it had to be somebody who's never been arrested.
Good luck.
No, I've given up on luck, so I might have to deal. Which leads me to my real question. Now, what time of day am I most likely to catch the DA in a generous mood?
Unfortunately, he's still too new to predict.
You bet. A couple months earlier, you could have given me the inside track.
What makes you think I had it?
Well, you know, you and Forrest Bedford, you clocked a lot of time together. Professionally, that's all I meant. So, did you do anything interesting over the weekend?
Rearranged my kitchen cabinets, wrote a couple of letters. Thinking about taking up canasta to keep myself busy until the spinsters' convention comes to town.
Christina, no one thinks of you as a spinster.
Really? How do they think of me?
Maybe a little mysterious, feisty, a maverick.
What does that mean?
I don't know. I'm just trying to tread water until the lifeboat shows up.
Hey. Just about to head over to your house.
What for? You want to see what a rapist looks like up close and personal?
I can't believe she's doing this.
Why not? She's a damn woman, ain't she? She put them all in a boat naming for a hurricane.
Have you thought about what you're gonna do? The Navy?
Guy down to recruitment center said he could get me out of here in a week.
What did you happen to mention that you're out on bail?
Why do they have to know that?
You think they're not gonna check? You think you're the first person to come up with this brainstorm?
People are always joining the Navy to get out of trouble.
Not this kind of trouble.
Well, they don't get a job driving a truck.
You can't leave town. Then you'd be a fugitive. You'd be in even more trouble.
Well, then she'll just have to tell the truth.
What makes you think she will?
Don't worry. When I get through with her, she'll tell the truth.
Paul, are you crazy?
Why is it that she can do whatever she wants? She can just waltz in there and lie. What if I went in there and told them that she robbed a bank 2 months ago?
You should talk to my dad. Well, maybe tomorrow, when you're thinking a little straighter.
What for?
You're gonna need a lawyer.
I can't talk to you, Big F.
Why not?
What am I gonna say to you? Guy used to take me on camping trips. Now I'm a rapist.
You think he's gonna believe that? Look, he knows about this stuff. At least he can tell you what to do.
Man, I'm trapped. The birds are pecking me apart.
Well, we made our slam.
Beth, your daughter should sit in with us more often.
If you keep going like this, you just might take high score away from Nancy for once.
Nancy hasn't won in weeks. You know, I don't think she can keep her mind on her game these days.
Why not?
Because first she'd have to take it off of Jerry Saunders.
You're kidding. I didn't even know that he and Ellen had split up.
They didn't.
Ooh, heavens.
Well, it'd be bad enough if she saw it for what it is, but she's living in this dream world where she thinks he'll leave Ellen and the kids in that beautiful house.
As if that ever happens.
Why buy the cow when you can get the milk for free? Well, Christina's gonna think we're just a pack of gossips.
Kay, I thought I saw Bill Jr. drive by the other day. Did he get a new car?
Every time he gets a promotion, he gets a new car.
Honey, you remember Bill Patterson, don't you? He went to school with you?
We see each other at the cafe about 5 times a week.
Well, no one ever accused Bill of knowing how to cook.
Didn't you go with him to the dance that year you were in the homecoming chorus?
I asked him to be my escort, and he was too polite to say no.
Oh, now Bill's always been crazy about you.
Is he going with anyone special right now?
Well, not that I know of.
Honey, you should call him sometime for lunch.
I have lunch 2 tables over from him every day.
Well, for dinner then. I'm sure he'd appreciate a home-cooked meal.
Mother, I think it's your turn to deal.
Nancy.
Well, you just tell that good-looking thing that if I were 20 years younger, you wouldn't have any trouble getting a home-cooked meal.
Dad, can we talk to you?
Sure. Sit down. Well, Paul, I guess I know what brings you here. I've heard the charges, but you'll have to fill me in on the story.
Mine or hers?
How about the truth?
You're the first person that's been interested in that.
He was going out with Parky Sasser. She got pregnant. She wanted to get married. He didn't want to. So she told the cops he raped her and had him arrested.
Have you spoken to an attorney?
I thought that's what I was doing now.
I mean someone who might represent you at the trial.
Why does there have to be a trial?
You may avoid a trial down the line. But first, you're going to need a lawyer.
Okay. Where do I get one?
There's no shortage of attorneys in this town. I can give you a couple of names.
What?
It occurs to me that under the circumstances, you'd probably be better off with a female attorney.
A woman? A woman got me into this mess. They all stick together.
Would you just shut up and listen?
A female attorney pleading your case will soften your image in court. Your accuser will appear less victimized during questioning, you understand?
I haven't understood anything since last week.
There's a woman named Christina Lakatsis, a very good attorney, and she's had experience with this kind of case.
Where am I going to get the money to pay for a lawyer?
You have a car, don't you?
Yeah, that's why I don't have any money.
He's saying you can sell it.
Sell my car? Some girl tells a lie about me and now I'm supposed to sell my car? No way! I'm gonna be buried in that car.
I'm sure you can work something out with Miss Lakatsis. But I'd advise you to go see her. The sooner the better.
Daddy, your face is as long as a wagon.
Whatever.
I've never seen anybody so afraid of a birthday.
Wait till you're my age.
I'm receiving RSVPs for your annual bash.
As long as they're not RIPs. Guess who I run into the other day? Living high on the hog and driving a big, fancy new cad rag top.
Nobody we know.
Nobody but your cousin Oscar, dressed to the nines. What?
Nothing.
Nothing looks like something.
I have a pretty good idea of how he got so high on the hog. Her polishing some white man's apples. Where's he working?
The Burning Creek Country Club. Man's got to make a living. There's no colored man in this town hire him after y'all closed down the pig mall. What do you want him to do?
Whatever troubles he has, he brought up on himself when he crossed the picket line and refused to stop cooking at a segregated lunch counter.
Did he answer the RSVP?
I didn't invite him.
He's my sister's child, my blood, and I think I want to invite him. His purple heart is in there on my dresser right now for safekeeping.
That's 101 times you've told me that, Daddy.
How you gonna explain to your Aunt Selma that you wouldn't invite her boy because he ain't got the right political stance? I'm not gonna tell you how old I'm gonna be.
I know how old you're gonna be, Daddy.
Old enough to have anybody I want at my birthday party.
It's your birthday party, Gary.
That's the first thing you got right.
I don't mean to sound insensitive, but what do you think this town considers a decent period of mourning?
I think that's something we're just going to have to sense as we go along.
If you and Gwen had gotten a divorce, there'd been some way we'd be moving on by now. The fact that she died just compounds all the guilt.
I get my share of sidelong glances.
It's not the same.
I know. I know it's not.
I don't know what to do when you agree with me.
I'm sorry.
No, I'm sorry. Just wallowing in martyrdom today. Feel free to stuff a pillow in that mouth.
I have more inventive ways of shutting you up. What if I pick you up tomorrow night We drive over to Greene County. We have dinner at Chez Michel's. How does that sound?
Sounds dangerously close to real life. Sounds lovely.
Corley's not gonna expect us to know like dates and crap, is he?
It's sort of the whole point of history, dates and crap.
Man, I'm gonna get killed.
Paul.
I'm just gonna talk to her. What the hell are you doing? Is this how you think you're gonna get me to marry you?
Leave me alone.
Because if it is, it ain't working.
I said leave me alone.
Leave you alone? You weren't the one stuck in some interrogation room all night. Will you just talk to me for 1 minute? Don't you owe me that?
I don't owe you nothing.
You're gonna start telling the truth if I have to wring it out of you.
Get your hands off of me!
Yep.
You can still dance all through the rope.
Oscar, those are some fine clothes.
Hey, you get what you pay for, and that's the truth.
How much does that cost you?
Ken.
His family.
Lewis used to be a fool for clothes. In school, they call him Holly. That's short for Hollywood.
That's right, they did.
Hey, I'll tell you a man who knows how to dress. That's Mr. Sonny Butcher. Has his golf sweaters flown in from Scotland.
Hey, ain't his daddy the one that invented that root beer with the foam so thick you can rest the bottle top on it?
Yeah, got two free cases on the back porch right now.
I tell you, these white folks are good to me as the day is long. See, out there on the lakes, we all the same. I mean, we pull our pants on one leg at a time.
I hear you pull theirs up for them.
Seems folks been talking behind my back.
You mean when they're not scratching it?
Daddy, can me and Theo have a second piece of cake?
Yeah, but don't eat the flour. That's too much sugar for your tea.
Thanks.
This ain't no political convention. It's my birthday party, so act accordingly. We're having fun.
But where was everybody at my 4th of July picnic? Everybody knows I have it every year. And that was fun, too.
Now, come on, let's not get into that now.
Come on, it's time to open my gifts, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah.
And there better be a lot of them, too.
I mean, where was my family?
Up in mine first, Grandpa.
Did y'all think I was off on some world tour?
Inez sent you the staples you needed, canned goods and clothes for the children.
But you didn't come to see me. Nobody came to my house.
As I recall, we came plenty of times, only to hear you swearing at the world and wanting to blame somebody, including your family.
Let's see what presents Lewis got.
Yeah.
From us, Uncle Lewis.
Yeah? All right.
Whoa!
Hey, that's top of the line now. I seen that advertised down at Reggie Edelman's store.
Yeah, plug it in.
Have a seat. This morning I had a conversation with Mr. Ashworth, the school superintendent. I'm required to keep him informed should any of our students find themselves in ignominious positions with the law. These charges against you are grave. We'd like to give you the benefit of the doubt, but in light of what happened in the hallway yesterday, we don't see how we can. We've decided to suspend you until this thing can be resolved.
What?
Effective immediately.
Well, what about my grades? I've been killing myself this year. I got a C average. What about wrestling?
It's a little late to be thinking about all that. Mr. Slocum, we've got this school's reputation to think of, and a duty to protect the young ladies who go here.
Tremble, thou earth,
amen,
at the presence of the God of Jacob.
Amen.
But not unto us, O Lord, not unto us.
Yes.
But unto thy name give praise.
Yes, yes, Lord.
Amen. For thy loving mercy,
amen,
and for thy truth's sake.
Well.
Amen.
Amen.
Tonight I must tell you, one of our brethren finds himself lost, and it is most hurtful to our cause. Mm-hmm. At this time, I'd like to read to you a letter published this morning in the Breland Examiner. It's to the editor and written by Oscar Wilson. Dear esteemed sirs, I am a colored citizen of Breland. Like you, I object and am shamed by the colored and white miscreants in the newspapers and on TV, demonstrating and disturbing the peace. If they can't find it in themselves to improve their lot in America like I have, then maybe they should consider going back to Africa. Referring to my esteemed colleague, Dr. King, our friend, Mr. Wilson, goes on to say, I wish Dr. King would stop going around agitating, asking some white man or the other for something without offering anything. This makes people think that we coloreds can't do nothing ourselves and that nothing's ever good enough. The white man's been good to us. I'm living proof of that. This is a dark and rainy day.
You're Lilly. Now, why do I get the premonition I don't want to read this?
Mother.
I was on my way home from choir practice, and I thought I'd just stop by and see if you had any plans for dinner. Obviously, the answer's yes.
Well, as a matter of fact,
you look absolutely gorgeous. Is it business or pleasure?
Hello. Hi. Oh. No, it's okay. I know you can't help it. I understand. I can't talk right now. We'll have to talk about this later. Bye.
So, do you suddenly find yourself available?
Mother, what is this all about?
What?
I make my living figuring out when people aren't telling me something.
I'm just tired of watching you waste your life on this ridiculous relationship with Forrest Bedford.
Mother, with all due respect, this is really none of your business.
I have to live in this town, too. I have to suffer the whispers and the looks. There goes Beth Lacatsis. Her daughter's having an affair with a married man.
He isn't married.
He was. Even if you married him for the rest of your life, you'd be that woman he was running around with when his poor wife died in that insane asylum.
My entire life doesn't hinge on the opinion of what passes for society in this town.
I just don't understand it. You're beautiful. You could have any man in this town.
Oh, really? Well, let's see. There's Corey Frith. I think he's been out of the pen long enough that it wouldn't hurt my social standing to go out with him.
Or there's J.T. Barber. If he could spit the tobacco out long enough to ask me.
But what about Bill Patterson?
It's really time to retire the Bill Patterson campaign.
Well, he's nice looking. He's got a terrific job.
He's a homosexual.
He is not.
Everyone knows it, Mother. Except your bridge club.
Well, if you want to waste your own life, that's one thing. But you don't have to go spreading vicious gossip about someone else to justify it.
Hi there.
What do you love
when you're
great?
Well, you'll be up next.
We'll see you.
You'll be up next. What do you think of that?
Well,
Lily, what brings you out my way?
Can I talk with you?
Yeah. Well, whoever said that great things are made up of small things wasn't lying. Well, what's on your mind?
Interesting reading in the paper lately.
Oh, you saw that? Well, I'm the first colored man to get published in the letter section.
No wonder it was a love letter. Oscar, you can't write things like that.
Why not? I was just exercising my right to free speech and press.
It's one thing to take advantage of a situation. It's another to sell your soul to it. Oscar, I've been proud of you all my life. You're my big, brave cousin who brought a medal home from the war. If anybody understood about what was worth fighting for, it was you. But now I see you going over to the other side, turning on your own people, and it hurts me.
How are they my people? When I lost my job, there wasn't a colored one of them in sight to help me out. Now, I know you believe in this movement. I mean, there are times when it sounds good to me, too. But after I lost my job, I realized that this movement isn't looking out for everybody.
Oscar.
It left me behind.
You get out of it what you put into it.
Same goes for the way I live.
There's more to life than making yourself comfortable. We have children to think of.
That's right. And it's a lot to be said for knowing where their next meal is coming from.
Oscar? Mr. Sumner has his four. He's waiting for his caddy.
Yes, sir, Mr. Petty. This is my cousin Lily, Mr. Petty.
Well, we sure do love your cousin. He's a fine boy.
Hello, Aunt Selma.
Hi, Lily.
I was just thinking about you. Come in. I was just thinking maybe I could borrow some of your sewing patterns to make Adelaine a school dress.
You know, Lily, over the years, you and I have usually seen eye to eye on things of a political nature. But I haven't always agreed with your approach. I know it was you who went to the country club and down-dressed my son in front of God and everybody. But we know where you get your high horse ways from. So don't tell me your daddy had nothing to do with it.
I haven't told you anything yet.
You've always thought you were Cleopatra. Even when you were a child, you whined and threw a fit until Oscar and your cousins played the games you wanted to play. And your daddy never lifted a finger to set you straight. Well, I'm sick of you two running roughshod over everybody. Do you understand? Where do you get off? Now, you may think you can put your nose in my business.
Well, if your business wasn't out in the street, I wouldn't be able to put my nose in it.
I'm not proud of Oscar's doings. He's not perfect. And neither are you.
You got a problem with me? Tell it to me. Don't come in here talking to my daughter like that.
I want you to apologize to my son. Both of you.
I don't see that we have anything to apologize for.
Well, until you have a vision, You just stay away from my family.
Evening. Hi.
Hi.
May I join you? Or would you rather I have a pitiful dinner by myself at another table?
I can't have that on my conscience.
Unless I'm interrupting your work.
My grocery list. I always give myself something to do. It makes me feel less self-conscious about eating alone.
You impress me as someone who's never had a self-conscious moment in her life.
Well, that proves that it works.
Look, I want to apologize for my faux pas the other day. I really didn't mean anything. Actually, I'm not sure whether I did or not. May I be blunt and possibly tactless?
You wouldn't be the first.
I'm very interested in you. And I don't know what to do about it because I don't know what the deal is between you and Forrest Bedford. Can you at least tell me if I'm making a complete fool of myself?
I can't reassure anyone of anything right now.
Just tell me to go away if you know without any uncertainty that I'm wasting my time.
Well, I don't want you to go away.
Good.
How's the card game?
It was all right. Did more drawing than playing.
I know why you're sad.
What do you want, a Nobel Prize?
It's not your fault.
I don't know. Seems like family should be the one place nobody's worried about your political stance. Everybody takes you for what you are.
If there was such a thing as neutrality, you could use whatever washroom you wanted. You could sit down at the lunch counter at the bus station and get served.
That boy fought for this country. Took a bullet in the Battle of the Bulls, fighting the Germans.
Daddy, Oscar was like a brother to me and Charlie. But we're in a war now. This isn't any different. There are spies and there are soldiers. People are dying.
I don't know. I might have said I'd marry her, but it was only because she was hysterical and I was trying to calm her down.
Why was she hysterical?
She got scared and started crying at this place that I took her for an abortion.
Abortion?
Oh, Polly.
Actually, this might work for us. You'd hardly ask a guy who raped you to drive you for an abortion.
I just want you to know that he was raised better than that.
But it's not like we're gonna have any trouble winning, right?
Can you remember where you took her for the abortion?
Someplace over in Boot Town. I can show you.
There's very little chance they'd be willing to testify for obvious reasons. Who told you?
Some colored guy at school, Robert Evans. His girlfriend knew the place.
You might have to call them in as witnesses.
Jury's not gonna believe me, but they're gonna believe a bunch of niggers.
We need someone to corroborate your story, given the fact that you're not gonna make the world's most attractive witness.
What the hell's that supposed to mean?
Parky Sasser is a good student. Her family's respected. And her father will be sitting front row center minus the arm he lost in the war. You have a low C average, history of outbursts and disrespect to authority,
and have recently been expelled from school for harassing the alleged victim. Plus, the DA's gonna have a field day with the fact that your father wouldn't come down and bail you out of jail.
So do you mean that we can't make these niggers testify?
If I were you, I wouldn't be so quick with name-calling. Because if the jury tries that, you're gonna fall into the category of white trash, which doesn't put you high enough on the totem pole to look down at anyone.
I ain't no white trash. You may know a lot of fancy words, but I know that this is America, and they can't put me in jail for something I didn't do.
Mr. Slocum, I'd advise you to shut your arrogant mouth for 5 minutes and hear what I am saying to you. This trial isn't going to be about what did or didn't happen. It's going to be about what the jury sees in front of them. A brash, arrogant hothead who shows not one grain of compassion for Parkey Sasser. And they might figure, you didn't do this and you did something else. Or you'll do something next week you might not get caught for. And there they sit, with the power to rid God-fearing society from the likes of you. And if you don't think there are a lot of innocent people who end up in jail that way, you take a poll when you get there.
How much would I get?
5 years, minimum.
Senate. Think you're in the North Pole.
Uncle Lewis, I'm holding the ball and it seems like you taught me.
Yeah.
My curveball drops right off the table.
That's good.
Hi, Uncle Lewis.
Hi, how are you, son? All right, boys, let's go outside. Well, sit down. Oscar, I remember a time when you listened to me, respected what I had to say.
I still do.
I talked to your mother. She's real put out with me. I'm used to that. Selma and I had our bust-ups before, but we always came through, one of us. Always blinked. I'm worried now that one of us won't. You got a decision to make, son.
That's my purple heart. I remember the day I gave that to you. I wanted you to keep it.
That was one of the proudest days of my life.
Before I went off to war, you taught me to look inside myself. And if that didn't scare me, then no man or machine could. And I always remember that. I've got a right to a good life. I've earned it.
Uncle Lewis.
Don't come to my house.
Daddy had a favorite verse he used to recite to me when I was young. It went, two men look through prison bars. One saw mud, the other stars. He said, everybody gets into a bad place at one time or another. What counts is how they come out of it, and that depends on where they set their sights. It seemed pretty simple then, but when I got older, I realized that sometimes the mud looks inviting and familiar, and the stars just seem a long way away.
On the next, I'll Fly Away.
I ain't cut out for this. I'm scared.
I want the name of the third man in that car.
You could be required by law to appear in court.
You can get me there, but you can't make me remember anything.
He raped me.
Order!
Is Adelaine Harper here?
I'm Adelaine Harper.
I'm your daddy.
Next week, we'll bring you two episodes of I'll Fly Away. In the first, Lilly receives a visit from her ex-husband, Walter. And in the second, Forrest releases Frankie to his new life on probation. Be with us for Since Walter and The Third Man, next Friday, beginning at 8. And stay with us now for a competition that combines athleticism, beauty, grace, rhythm, and glamour. Championship Ballroom Dancing 1994 is next.